I want to advance. I want to excel. You know, I would like to have my name and my face on that Mount Rushmore of calisthenics when everything is said and done, whether it's for age group, whether it's for weight group, or whether it's just for individuals that have set a benchmark or a standard. Whatever it is, I want my name to be left on that Mount Rushmore. So, and I already know that that mountain is already filled. I gotta knock somebody off. So there's work that still has to be done. Any other athlete, I would just encourage them, work on yourself. Don't be sidetracked or sidelined by other athletes. You are who you are, and you're only going to get better by changing yourself. It's not going to be better for you if another athlete starts to decrease or decline. You're only going to get better when you start to increase and you start to advance, when you move to a stage of eliteness. Because there's something that, you know, I've always told myself, because you might be the best doesn't mean that you're excellent. And at times, because you might have shown that there is excellence in what you do, it doesn't mean that you're the best, because somebody might be better despite your excellence. So these are things that if you understand, yes, I strive for excellence, I strive to be the best, but at times the two of them may not go hand in hand, that there's still work that needs to be done. You're never going to stop, you're never going to attain, you know, 100% proficiency. So, you know, for myself, I know that this is an ongoing challenge until I'm ready to step away. And I really don't want to step away despite what competitions I do or despite what events I might enter into. I really don't want to stop until I get to that Mount Rushmore. I'm excited about the competition, actually. It's something that I'm looking forward to give myself a benchmark or some type of measurement as far as where I'm at pertaining to this particular challenge. Initially, when it was presented, I thought that it was light work. I worked through the regimen a couple of sessions, and I actually found it to be something very challenging. So for myself and for the other athlete or the other competitor, which is Rascal, I hold him in high esteem. I hold him in high esteem because of his accomplishments, and I hold him in high esteem because of the group, the Barbarians, that he's a part of. And I also hold him in high esteem because he's been able to maintain that training, that competition, and that level of proficiency under Zef, who I have great and tremendous respect for in terms of this calisthenics exercise and movement. And he's one of the faces on Mount Rushmore, so I know I have to go beyond Rascal if I'm trying to get to Mount Rushmore. But I think it's going to be a great challenge. I think it's going to be something for myself and for himself that if we're able to approach it correctly, it's going to raise the eyes of other athletes that might be a little younger than us, that maybe one day me and him going to tag team somebody else that might be younger than us, that we can show them. It's dependent upon your training, your approach, and your input on what you put into yourself is what you're going to get out. You're not going to get anything except but what you put into it. So as far as the workout and the event that's coming up, I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking to go in and just exhibit proficiency in terms of form, execution, stamina, endurance. And I'm looking for the same from Rascal, because I know he's going to bring it. And I think it's going to be a real great battle. But I think it's going to be something that it raises the eyebrows and the attention of more than just the individuals who are in our age group that are doing this particular event.